lovelies. So, I guess the first thing to do is to talk about it. And so I'm going to talk about why September is such a difficult month for me. Okay, so I'm going to try to do it as fast as possible because for some reason if I feel like if I do it really fast then I won't hysterically cry. So when I was just a little youngin', my best friend, she got pregnant and had a baby, and it was the most precious baby in the entire whole wide world. And her name was Adria, and I like lived and breathed for that child. And I my whole life like never wanted children. Like when I got to the age where like I have kids, everyone's like, "Oh, you'll change your mind, da 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 da," and I'm like, "No, no, that is not something that God put on my heart. Like, put on my heart very much to like love others' children." That sounds really creepy, but not in a creepy way. But like, very good with kids, but I never, ever, ever, like, to the point where I'm like, is this gonna be a problem with a husband? Like, I need to look for a guy that actually doesn't want kids. Like, it's really important to me. Like, I don't feel like I want kids. And everyone's like, "Oh, change your mind. Like, you're so great with kids, blah, blah, blah." And I really wasn't. And so when Adria was born, like, I really truly felt like, oh, God, this is what you're like. This is why. And like when she, I remember people always being like, "Oh, do you want to have kids when you get older, when you get married?" And I'm like, "No, I already have a daughter. Her name's Adria." And my best friend is such a good mom, and they were just really, really tight. And I got to live with them for a year in Chapel Hill, which was really cool. Unfortunately, I was doing very poorly mental health wise. With my anxiety and depression during that time, but I just have really, really amazing memories of her there. And she was the most kind, giving child, intelligent. I mean, like, yeah, most people say this about their kids, but she's legit not my kid, and I say this about her. I was dating a guy, and he had to move around a lot for his job, and Bella, can you come here? I dated someone, he moved around a lot, so I remember I was in a motel room, and I got a mass text that said Adria was killed this morning, and I tried calling her mom, and I called her over and over and over again. Of course, she didn't answer. And then I called her mom's sister, or Adria's aunt, and I just remember screaming and begging her sister to tell me that it was just some sick prank. And it wasn't. She was 5 years old, and she was killed every year. In September, I experience it over and over again, and it was really hard for a long time because I felt a lot of pressure to like forget about her and like get past it. And like I felt like, what's wrong with me? Like, am I just holding on to this? Like, I also lost that friendship when Adria passed, so I feel very much like almost like a death bear. And everybody that knows me knows I don't deal well with death at all, even of like an animal, let alone a little person that I loved with like every fiber of my being. And like it's, I think I have a hard time because I saw my future in her. And I think that's like pretty natural for parents, but it's hard because I felt like I didn't have the right to mourn her because I wasn't her mom. I wasn't even related to her. So it's been a process, and I've learned that I don't have to forget about her. I don't have to just get past it. It is going to hurt me. It's going to come up, and I'm going to think about her and laugh, and I'm going to think about her and smile, and then there's going to be times where I think about her and cry, and that's okay. And that I have every right to mourn her and the loss of her as anybody that just met her one single day out of her life. And I always draw solace in the fact that she will never know sin, and that she was meant to be here for those 5 years, and that's it. And she never knew pain. She just knew the greatest things about life, and she just lived the crap out of life. I mean, she really lived the 5 years of her life, and she's an amazing example, and she's 5 years old. There's just something really special about her. I truly, truly believe she was an angel on earth. I am very blessed that I got to know her and to be around her and help raise her. It just really hurts that she's not here anymore and that I didn't get to see her grow. And, you know, I just look at a lot of things I'm blessed with now and just wish that I could share them with her. And you're never going to have that relationship again. Not that relationship. There's going to be others, but not that one. I just miss her so much all the time. But September is just a particularly hard time. Usually I think like it's the day, but for me it's the entire month. And I just dread it every year. It's just really tough on me every single day. That's the one thing that I say, like, I will spend the rest of my life missing her. She was just so amazing. Like, I don't really remember a lot about her funeral or anything like that, but I just remember the church that it was at, and there were, like, wall-to-wall people. Every single pew full. And this was a huge Catholic church. People were standing. There was no space for people. Like, gosh, like if I had a funeral, I'd be lucky if I could fill up like the smallest church place around here. But that child had so much reach and touched so many people. It was incredible. She really was magic. And I miss her very much. You know, mourning is for the people that are here. And she was my kid, and I loved her the best way I could. And of course, I could have done more and been there more. But you can't change the past, and I just really miss her. It's really tough. But one thing about her is that every time I talk to her, she would say she loved me, and I would say I love her. So that's one thing I can never regret, is that she knew I loved her and I knew she loved me. And I think that's really, really freaking special. Because I know the last words out of her mouth to me were, I love you much. And that was just something she said. She always said, I love you much. I'm just glad that her grandmother is with her now. The only thing that like I can really take solace in now, because her gram helped raise her, so she was a really special lady too. The whole family is just really special, and I miss them a lot. But so that's something that's really hard for me to talk about, but I tell you guys everything and I don't feel like I'm presenting myself in a truthful way if I leave that out, even though I don't want to be crying and bringing things down. That's what the pain in my eyes is in September and most other days, but particularly in September. If I could ask for anything, it would be prayers for her family. Because for as much as I loved her, they loved her 1,000 times more, and I can't imagine that kind of pain. I don't even like to try to think about it. Her and her mom were best friends. It's been a long time, and I think people just expect like it to go away. Like when a grandparent passes, and then like a couple years later, it's like, oh, remember when? And just like fond memories. But I think when like a child is taken in such a difficult way, I don't know. Screw it. I don't care how anyone else deals with it or justifies it. This is my pain, and I will never get over her. Ever. In my whole life, I will never get over her. And I will never stop missing her. Not one single day. And that's my truth. So I'm not going to apologize for it, and I'm not going to make excuses for it. That's it. So thank you guys for watching this video. It means a lot to me, especially if you've gotten to this point. I'm really sorry if you've experienced loss in any capacity. It's something that I don't know how to deal with, so I'm not going to be much help, but I wanted to be truthful with you guys as I am in my illness and my mental illness and all of that. And I know I've mentioned several times that September is very difficult for me. I hope you guys are having a pain-free, stress-free day. Hug the people you love. Tell them you love them. Never leave a conversation on a bitter note. Always leave it with I love you much. Alright guys, I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.